For the use of RUX, we've had the special considerations listed in the guidelines, new ones, I believe, just came out for fedratinib. One issue I'd like to touch on is that there was a controversial report, I think a year or so ago, from Europe, talking about the possibility of JAK inhibitor therapy leading to an increased risk of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. And while it was a general JAK inhibitor related phenomenon, as the authors put it, the vast majority of their patients, in fact, had ruxolitinib, obviously, because that was the approved drug. So that has been mentioned in the special considerations. But the reason I bring it up is that we already know that lymphoma is more common in patients with myeloproliferative neoplasms. Several groups, including ours, have shown that. And specifically, after this report got published, we looked at our experience at MD Anderson and published, actually in the same journal, both reports are in Blood, that this is not the case. We did not see an increased risk of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma in our ruxolitinib-treated patients, as opposed to those who did not receive ruxolitinib. So we do not feel this to be a real phenomenon, and I believe it is important for the NCCN guidelines to include both those points of view, or rather both those pieces of data. So that's a comment that definitely I would make, and also the fact that the original study really refers to JAK inhibitors as a whole. So if at all this were an effect, I think it would be a class effect and not just for one drug. However, I don't really feel there is a real risk there at all.